What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 11 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. I couldn't even get my intro out, and I got attacked by a wild Pokemon. You're not even worth my time. Anyways, last time, as you recall, I got lost here in Ilex Forest looking for the guy that teaches Headbutt. Now that I've done a little bit of research, I now know where to go, and unfortunately, I'm going to have to do a bit of walking to find him. I'm not going to bother with these wild Pokemon. They're really not worth my time at this point. And right away, these guys are relentless. I'm less than a minute in. I've already been attacked 3 times. Oops, wrong turn there. Got to go through here again. Basically, I'm gonna have to make a giant arc here. There's the guy. I'm gonna have to loop around here. This was the path that I overlooked earlier. And here's the guy that teaches Headbutt. He's headbutting trees right now. I'm gonna go ahead and teach Headbutt to... I'll just give it to Quilava here. He needs another physical attack here. I'll get rid of quick attack here. I think he's quick enough that he doesn't need the quick attack. Now, starting in the gold and silver version of the game, you can now use Headbutt as a field move in order to headbutt these trees, and if you're lucky, you can get a Pokemon to pop out. And I'm going to need to use this method to get the next member of my team. Hopefully we'll see him right here, right now. Nope, all we get is a level 5 Caterpie. I'm actually not surprised. The guy I'm looking for is gonna be a lot rarer find. Even though I have not yet caught Caterpie, I may as well go for it now. A little hesitant to throw any attacks. I think one attack would knock it out. I'm wasting Pokeballs here. Let's go ahead and bring in Flaffy. Maybe if I paralyze it, I'll be able to catch it without dealing any damage. Here goes. Alright, paralysis hit. Caterpie is vulnerable. Now let's see if we can catch it. Excuse me. I had a cough the past couple days. I think this should do it here. No? This guy's being more of a pain in the neck than I thought he'd be. Hope this does knock it out. Good it didn't. Okay, if this doesn't work, I'm just gonna... I don't know what I'm going to do, but it's going to involve mentally torturing myself that I couldn't catch a level 5 Caterpie with a Pokeball. Luckily, that's not the case here. Chalk one more up for the Pokedex. Start headbutting trees and making our way through the forest here. Nothing there. He tripped over his feet there. Go ahead and put Flaffy up front. That way I can hit paralysis as soon as a wild Pokemon comes. Hopefully it'll be the guy I'm looking for.
I
already caught Oddish. Let's try this tree. Or how many concussions I'm going to give Quilava before we finally catch our fifth team member. I'm going to go ahead and head back to Azalea Town and heal up here. Now I do believe there are also some trees here that I can headbutt as well. And I do believe my next team member could be hiding in one of those. So I think I'll cruise around Azalea Town before I start heading back through Ilex Forest. I'm going to go ahead and deposit Caterpie and Oddish here. Not going to need them. Making pretty good progress with the Pokédex so far. They've got maybe 20 odd or something like that. Let's head by this tree. Maybe this one? I just hope it doesn't take too long to catch this guy. I got a call from Wade here. Yeah, I am playing this very late at night. Wade's got some berries I can get from him. I'm not going to worry about that right now. I am going to go in here, though, before I move any further. Here we can get Charcoal, which if you give to a Pokemon, it'll increase the power of Fire-type moves by 20%. So it's a perfect item for Quilava here at this point. Have him hold it. Therefore, that Ember of his will get a nice little burst of power. Did forget to do that earlier. All right, let's continue our search. And Quilava's gonna need a lot of aspirin to recover from this once we're done here. The torture will hopefully be over soon, Quilava. Is this it? No. It's a lousy Spearow, level 3. You just get a little EV speed for Flaffy here. Experience is minimal. I will not give up, though, until I catch this guy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is how you give your Pokemon a concussion. You headbutt trees. Repeat endlessly. Okay, now we're talking. Here's the guy I was looking for. Heracross. Bug fighting type worth 2 EV points in attack. However, I'm not fighting this guy for the experience. I'm fighting to add him to the team. Flaffy has hit paralysis already. I believe he only knows Horn Attack and Leer at this point, so hopefully this guy won't be too much of a problem here. I'll keep Flaffy in. I'll try a Pokeball here. I don't think it's going to be enough, though. Maybe. Never mind. I'm really hesitant on using an attack here. Because again, I've got a 13 level advantage over him, and I'm afraid I may knock him out here. I don't want to do that, or else it's going to take me forever to find him again. I got really lucky finding Heracross this soon. I expected it to take a lot longer. I was expecting to do some off-camera searching and starting an episode with the battle. Man, I've gone through three Pokeballs so far. He also has Endure, apparently. Guarantees that he'll survive the next attack. I took a big chance there. Let's go for the Pokeball again. Two left. One last Pokeball here before I have to go into my special Pokeballs. I will not be denied. You will be mine. Oh yes, you will be mine. I got a secret weapon, and it's called a netball. Let's see you get out of this one. Heracross, welcome to the team. Now, I'll tell you the story about how I decided to have this guy on my team. As you know, if you've been watching this walkthrough so far, I requested ideas for team members. I initially planned to pick my starter, but a couple people went ahead and picked Cyndaquil for me anyway, so I decided to go ahead and pick one Pokemon for myself, and I chose this guy, Heracross. I'm going to go ahead and teach him Cut. Apparently he's already got four moves. What else has he got? He's got Tackle, Leer, Horn Attack, and Endure. I'll go ahead and, let's see, what should I drop here? I'll drop Tackle. Horn Attack is actually a pretty good attack. And Heracross has very good, I take that back, excellent attack power. And very good speed, so it's going to be a very good powerhouse for my team. I'm also going to teach it Rock Smash. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of Endure here. In my opinion, Endure was a poorly planned move. It's a good idea, but not really that effective in versus battles. And now I got a Rock Smasher on my team as well. Like I mentioned in a previous episode, I'm not going to use HM Slaves at all. Now our team has grown to five, and we won't see the final team member until we hit, I believe, Ecruteak City, which is still a few episodes out. I got a lot of work to do with Heracross, but hopefully with good attack power, it shouldn't be too hard. But now I gotta get through Ilex Forest here. I'm gonna let Heracross take the lead. Guys in Ilex Forest will only have a couple levels on him, so hopefully he can gain experience quickly. I'll go ahead and fight some of these guys. I mean, Heracross is an excellent Pokemon. Unfortunately, because of its type bug fighting, it's got a double weakness to flying. So you gotta be cautious of who you let this guy battle. Luckily, this Ash is just using Sweet Scent to reduce my evasion. It's not attacking at all. To be fully honest with you, I don't think Absorb will do that much damage. But we're gonna see how much exactly. One hit point, yeah. That's as low as you can go there. Heracross, slowly but surely winning this battle, wins it with Cut, gets a nice little hunk of experience. One battle, got it to level up. Got a full level out of that. Who's calling me now? Ralph. I'm wondering if I should just stop answering my phone, because honestly, a lot of that's just worthless information there. And it's getting late. I gotta go to bed soon. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this all the way to the end of the forest and call it quits. See if I can get any new Pokemon for the Pokedex by headbutting some trees. Yeah, I said to him the torture would end soon, but I'm just going to prolong it just because I feel like it. See who we got here. Oh wow, a Butterfree. Fully evolved Pokemon. You don't see these too often. I think, though, Heracross may have some difficulty here, especially with that confusion. That may put him down for the count. No, he didn't. Okay. But I'm definitely going to yank him right here. And, bring in, let's see, who? Quilava. Good thing I got him out of the way. That confusion would have knocked him out. And that Ember did the trick. Heracross is going to level up again. Another Oddish. Heracross is a little weak now, but should be able to handle this guy no problem. It may take him a few attacks, but luckily his attack power is rising quickly with these natural level ups here. I think one more horn attack should do him in. Ooh, critical. Should do it. Yes, there it is. Okay. And, Heracross didn't quite get enough for a level up there. We made it to the end. Let's headbutt one more tree. Nothing. Alright. Well, I think at this point I'm going to go ahead and heal up real quick with a potion, and I'm going to call it quits here. And in the next episode, I think we'll finally hit Goldenrod City, so I'll see you then. Until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.